All right, reactions have now started pouring in. Congress has hit back after Pawar's attack on Rahul Gandhi. This is the first reaction from the Congress. Salman Khurshid saying that the attack on Rahul Gandhi is unfair, adding that the alliances come and go, but Congress's interests are supreme for Rahul Gandhi. Listen in.
As far as your former ally NCP is concerned, Mr. Sharad Pawar has said that Rahul Gandhi marginalizes the allies, and it is because of him primarily that the alliance did not go through.
Well, I can't, I'm not party to that decision, and I don't have inside knowledge and information, but I will say one thing, that Mr. Rahul Gandhi has a very explicit determination to ensure that the Congress party remains strong and a driving force. Now, when somebody is so determined and so singularly committed to an idea of primacy and dominance of the party, maybe other people don't understand it, and I think they need to engage in a greater dialogue to understand what our objectives are. After all, we were singularly minded about not going into alliances when we went to Simla. In Simla, we agreed that we would look at alliances and the possibility of alliances. And thereafter, we looked at alliances in two long terms, 5 years and 5 years. We have worked at the center in alliances, which sometimes were running into trouble, but by and large, I think we've done a good job. But I don't think that the alliances have to force you to redefine yourself. They certainly encourage accommodation and require accommodation and adjustment, but you can't redefine your core principles and your core objectives of your own party. And I think it would not really be very fair to say that Mr. Rahul Gandhi's determination to keep his party as number one and to move forward faster and greater and to have a historical perspective from the past informing the kind of party he wants to see ourselves be part of in the future. I don't think it's fair to comment on that if you're not within the party.
All right, to talk about this, I have with me Sahil Joshi joining us live from Mumbai, Ashar Khan joining us live from Delhi. Ashar, coming to you first, the Congress's first reaction coming out very strongly. Now this war of words has started between the Congress and the NCP, allies for the past 50 years. Is this sign enough that these two parties are going to be each other's political rivals?
Well, that is virtually out in the open since the alliance broke, because everybody would be contesting elections against each other. But the basic thing here is that, after all, there was a thinking in the Congress before the Simla session, as Salman Khurshid pointed out, that the Congress will not need allies, it will go on its own. In fact, we've seen that Rahul Gandhi has been a big proponent of that school of thought within the Congress, which says that let's go back to our roots, let's go back to the basics and ensure that the Congress is developed at grassroots levels, at booth levels, at the block levels, at district levels. Now, okay. We've seen that this has not worked very well for Rahul Gandhi as far as the assembly elections of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar are concerned, if we take the last two assembly elections. But yes, at the central level, there has been accommodation, there has been a lot of adjustment vis-a-vis the basic core values of the Congress is concerned. And that is what perhaps Salman Khurshid is trying to articulate in this.
Okay, Ashar, do stay on with us. Going to Sahil Joshi now. Sahil, we were talking about these several important points being made by Sharad Pawar while he was speaking exclusively to you in this interview. But one thing is very clear, you know, the fight is on in Maharashtra and the attack is much more direct from Sharad Pawar this time.
Absolutely. In fact, after 15 years of working together in Maharashtra, the Congress NCP is now against each other, and Sharad Pawar is targeting Congress rather than Congress targeting BJP and Sena. Every party is contesting separately, so that has kind of given a chance to Sharad Pawar to attack whoever he wants to attack at this point of time. And his main target, as we can see, is Rahul Gandhi and Prithviraj Chauhan in Maharashtra, because according to Pawar, it was Rahul and Prithviraj, both of them actually tried to sabotage NCP chances in Maharashtra. They tried to defame NCP in Maharashtra, and that is the reason why after Ajit Pawar, now it is Sharad Pawar who has clearly attacked Rahul Gandhi and said, as he was speaking to me in the interview, that how Rahul Gandhi and his team was trying to marginalize Congress allies since beginning, and it was bound to happen. What happened in Maharashtra, the Congress NCP alliance broken. It has happened because they thought that it was planned by Rahul and his team. Prithviraj Chavan, who came in Maharashtra four years back after they had to remove Ashok Chavan as the chief minister, even Prithviraj Chavan, he clearly said that Prithviraj Chavan was trying to take revenge from NCP because he had to face defeat in 1999 by a known NCP candidate. So right. It's an out and out attack on Prithviraj and Rahul Gandhi at this point.
Absolutely. And also a couple of points being made clearly in favor of BJP over there, praising Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And what does one make of it, though he didn't really say anything about a post-poll tie up there?
See, that question is still open, because even if I try to push him to answer this question, that what will be the post-poll scenario? Will there be realignment of political parties? Will there be a post-poll alliances in Maharashtra? On that, he kept insisting that this is the time, this is the election, it's a historical election when every party is dreaming of having its own government. Especially after Lok Sabha elections, every party thinks that the people in India are in a mood to give chance to form the government to a single party, a single largest party. They will support a single party rather than going ahead with an alliance, because that is the best way of running the government in the state. So even Sharad Pawar thinks that NCP has high chances of getting close to the 144 margin which is required to form the government on its own. But the history says that NCP's missile has a range of 60 miles. NCP has never passed the benchmark of 60 seats in Maharashtra on its own. Even in 99, they could only reach 56. Their best performance in Maharashtra was 72, and that is also with Congress. So this is the election which NCP has to face alone, and will it will decide NCP's future as far as
Absolutely,
Maharashtra politics
Sahil,
is concerned.
Not just the NCP, all parties in fact going to go alone in the state of Maharashtra. But Ashar, what sense are you getting from the Congress as far as their strategy goes this time? Because it's going to be a challenge for the Congress party as well, apart from all the other parties, as we mentioned, who are fighting it alone this time.
Well, at the moment, what they are harping on is the clean image of the incumbent Chief Minister Prithviraj Chauhan of the Congress. They've said that there were issues, that's why we changed the Chief Minister. Now, in the last 4 years, he's given you good governance, he's given you clean governance. That is what is going to be the plot which the Congress is going to play. But apart from that, what the Congress has been thinking in a very long term, that there was almost more than half seats which the Congress never contested in the last 15 years. And that is something which the Congress thinks it did not enthuse the cadre. The Congress was finished in those districts, in those assembly constituencies, and this is a good opportunity to ensure that the Congress workers, the Congress leaders at that small grassroots level revive. Right. But deep down, as far as these elections are concerned, the hopes are not very high as far as the Congress is concerned.
Okay, Ashar and Sahil, thanks so much for joining us. Of course, this battle for Maharashtra has become very interesting after these developments over the past few days.